Hi guys, Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome to Let's Play Civilization 6 for the Island Plates Japan Emperor and Chill game. And we're churning along, we have a few things to get through here in this turn. And namely, I'm kind of running out of things to do with these builders until I take all these cities and can actually get improving these lands. So why don't you just like go to sleep here and we'll end the turn. He wants peace and I do not. I will take his one city Tiver, or Tver, I don't know how to say it, but I'm just going to say Tver. I'm going to take Tver and then sue for peace. So that's going to be the end of the turn. And we just unlocked Gunpowder, which is the nitre resource. And we should have a look around. There is some nitre over here. Is that really the only nitre we found in the entire game? We got no nitre on our initial island. This is the sort of stuff that makes me, I don't know if I would say angry, but just frustrated with some of the design decisions that they made in Civilization 6. I love the game, but some of the things, it just feels like they were obviously a little bit weird and not gonna work well with some of the other elements of the gameplay. Like the overarching ideas are great, but there's like these small sort of adjustment decisions, like the sort of strategic resource for units. The idea behind that is great. If we like talk about it, like let's have a look at nitre. The idea behind units requiring strategic resources is great, but the problem is that it's inconsistent. Like, let's have a look here, right? This unit doesn't need a specific resource. This unit does. And like, what makes this unit special? Why does the musketman need a strategic resource, but like the infantry doesn't? Do you know what I mean? Why does the bombard need nitre and the artillery doesn't? Why does the battleship need coal but the submarine doesn't? Why does the fighter need aluminum but the, I guess they all need aluminum, don't they? Yeah, but like, you know, why doesn't the mechanized infantry need, you know, uranium or something for the uranium armor? I just feel like it's a great idea. It just feels inconsistent if the resources aren't spread equally and balanced, and if those resources are not, what's the word? All it feels like is that you're technologically hampered by something you can't even plan for. I have no control, okay? Yeah, that's exactly it. I'm okay with RNG and things that players can't control in a game, but I feel like I have no control over whether or not I have nitre in my empire. And then people are going to say, well, you can go kill someone for nitre. I'm like, yeah, okay, that's true. But the problem is with the way the game is at the moment, even if I go kill someone with nitre, by the time I slog through that war and kill them who has nitre, you know, the unit that the nitre builds is obsolete and irrelevant to the outcome of the game. And that kind of sums up my feelings on the strategic resources. They just don't feel like they do anything but hinder a player. That they honestly just feel like they hinder gameplay at the moment in the current iteration. Hinder fun and interesting outcomes. I might do a tile purchase here. I'm not against it. And it would help this city grow, I think, because it has some pretty crappy tiles. I want to get out of this production screen, thank you very much. I'll drop a fishing boat here. And then if I re-jigger things, yeah, that's a much better tile. And you should grow probably in a long, long time. Oh my god, this production bar went negative and it's all like back here and stuff. That's weird. That's very, very weird, but not the kind of fake YouTuber screeching weird. The kind of normal, that's odd. That's something I miss, all right? Can we just talk about this for a second? By the way, you're in for a rant episode, okay? I feel like people can't just be, like, slightly weirded out by things anymore. Everything has to be incredibly, incredibly dramatic. I'm kind of losing my voice here, actually. I've been talking for a while. Maybe I should go get a drink of water. But everything has to be so dramatic. Like, it can't just be like, that's weird. It has to be like, oh my god, guys, check this out, it's unbelievable. Whoa. Like, dude, it's just like, calm it down like about three notches and chill the hell out, alright? This isn't like something crazy, it's just a little bit weird. I don't know why you're acting like it's a big deal. Okay, so we took the city to Ver. Let's make peace. I want to keep Tver. He's happy with this deal. He'll give you a bunch of gold to him. Yeah, we'll take that deal. Give you a city. Take that. Goodbye. But yeah, like, it can't just be... Things can't just be chill. The world lacks chill. That's my problem. The world has begun to lack chill. You can't just be... not even stoic or neutral or whatever. You just can't be like... Am I just wrong? Am I wrong here that maybe the overreaction is the way it should be? It just feels, whenever I see this thing where people are like going crazy over stuff, it feels somehow dishonest in a lot of times. Now, sometimes something is genuinely amazing and awesome and it deserves that response. But I feel like if you do that for everything, you just cheapen it and kind of ruin it. I'm plundering trade routes. I can't even think of a good examples, but you've all probably seen this thing I'm talking about where, and it's not even just YouTubers, like people in general are starting to do it and it kind of bothers me a little bit. But it doesn't bother me in the sense that I think, oh, the world is going to end and things are going to hell. I just think it's like, this is just mildly annoying to me and I don't like it. it's just like, this is something I'm not personally a fan of in a great capacity. And even that, like, even something like that, I feel like there's like an entire culture building up now in some places where it's like, you can't even be like, yeah, I'm not a fan of that. Like, everything has to be like the extremes of emotion. Like, oh my God, that's fucking shit. Fuck that. I hate it. It's shit. Fuck that. Everything about it is shit. You should die and get cancer and fuck yourself. And like, it's like, okay. Okay, like, let's dial that back a notch and be like, yeah, I didn't like it. And then, like, I mean, sure, all right, fair enough. It's more entertaining to do it the extreme way where you go on a tirade and you talk shit about something for a while. That's really entertaining. And there's a time and a place for that, absolutely. But I feel like we're not making time and place for the other stuff, or at least I'm not seeing people do it. And I'm worried we're going to lose that. Although maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm just concerned trolling and... Maybe I'm like, think of the children. Oh my God. Maybe I'm doing that inadvertently. Where am I? I accidentally alt-tabbed out of the game. Now we have Kyoto here. City could use some growth. Could I get an aqueduct? It's already on fresh water, so it doesn't need an aqueduct. I could get an armory for the production. I think I will do that. Maybe a pretty good decision in my opinion. Grab me a watermill. I need to start making units, and I can't remember what the breakpoint was for making units. I think it's when I finish conquering Sumeria, I'm just going to start swarming the globe in units. I say swarming the globe in units, but I'm not going to be making that many. I'm going to be making a few, and quite a many, actually. Why don't you head down here? I actually don't know what to do with these builders. I stole so many that I've got builder mental attrition. I don't know what to do with them. I think it's probably time to do a little bit of a survey of our cities. You have how many unimproved tiles? You have quite a few. Can I wake up this builder and get this tile improved? No. Get this tile improved. That's really important. I don't make that mistake. Go here and what? Rest here. You should level up this builder. What? You have three tiles. I think you're actually good on tile improvements. This is going to be a pretty good city. Oh my God. I just noticed how much frickin' wheat is in this city. Jeez. 420 grain it. Mother of God. Yeah, this builder will just sleep for a while. I don't know what to do with it. Although, this city doesn't need a builder. This city doesn't need a builder. This city definitely needs one build charge. So let's get a builder over there. You go over to Kyoto. Asaka, how do you feel? You have almost all of your tiles improved, actually. You mainly just need to grow and drop districts and stuff. That would be a pretty accurate analysis, in my opinion. What are you doing? You have pretty much all your tiles improved as well. You could improve that fish. And I think we will get a builder over to you soon, TM. Go up here. I'm going to shoot there. And bam. But yeah, how do you feel? Do you think I'm like saying something sensible there about the whole people can't just be like chill anymore? Is it one of those things where I have become the old man screaming at children on his lawn? It's like, we used to do things differently, and is that just the way things people do things now? Is that just the things way people do things now? Did I just really say that sentence? Okay. Is that just the way people do things now? And fair enough, okay, you're allowed to have your own culture, sort of. You're allowed to have your own social culture. In that, the way you interact with your peers, the same way my generation had it, and all that sort of stuff, but... you know... I don't know, maybe it seems shallow to me? Maybe, and you know, it could be, again, it could be that thing I'm talking about where I'm criticizing some other generation, and the generation above me would have had the same criticism for me. Where they would say, you know, the way the youth now, they interact, it's all wrong. So, I mean, there's probably a little bit of that in here. Yeah, you need to make a workshop and just get your production up to a somewhat reasonable level. Okay, you made a builder. Let's have a look at the tiles you're working. I think we need farms. We need a farm, at least, because you are not growing at all. And I think I will preferentially work that, and then we're going to chop out that forest. You have to repair your monument. Unit needs orders. Make your way over here. You also need to make your way over here. You're making your way. Yeah, get that iron online. That doesn't seem like a bad idea to me. Will you allow us to establish an embassy? Yes, you're more than welcome to establish an embassy. I am in sixth place when it comes to religious victory, but I'm dominating in the domination victory. Culture victory, they're pretty far away from it. Let's see here. Privateers. Okay, we unlocked privateers. We're going to want to build those. Replaced by the sea dog. Ow, I just think I bumped into my microphone. Logistics, and here's a trade route policy that we wanted, actually. Now, here is an interesting question. Do we keep these? I think we get rid of the unit upgrade discount, because we're not looking to upgrade units right now. And we could probably slot something else in here. Excuse me. I thought I unlocked 100% campus adjacency bonuses, but I could have been wrong there. I don't really have any good things to slot in here. I mean, logistics is... yeah, logistics works. It gives a bit of movement to my builders and stuff. Yeah, I think I pretty much... like, look at this. I pretty much skipped an entire side of the tree. I don't know. This just feels wrong. This just feels wrong. You shouldn't be able to do that. I mean, I have... I'm able to fully explore and navigate the world without getting the ability to record history. How do my people have context for anything they've done if they don't record history? I don't even have theology, and yet people are talking about gods to me. I don't even have civil service, and yet somehow I'm doing all these things and have a huge centralized government. I don't know. Feels wrong. Feels wrong, man. Like, I can keep going here. I could go all the way up this colonialism tree, make it to conservation. In fact, I could get all the way to cultural heritage. No. Conservation? No, I could get all the way to natural history. Okay, let's just think about that. I can get all the way... maybe... is this what they want? Do they want you to pick a side of the tech tree to go down? I can get all the way to natural history without ever getting recorded history. That just seems wrong. That just seems wrong to me. In fact, I can almost get to urbanization without that. I don't know. That feels wrong. Colonialism. So what do we want to pick up here? I don't need any of these. We can backfill. We have diplomatic service. This is where spies come in, I think. Is it? Oh, no, no. Spies come in. Where do spies come in? Medieval fairs? No. It's one of these. Yeah, it is. It is. It's diplomatic service. Enlightenment. Let's do something fun here. Let's go for civil engineering. Drop a farm here. Why did you go that way? Go into the water again. Let's see. I think I'm gonna drop a settler over here. Can I settle in place? Yeah, I think it is because I can purchase the incense. And I think actually I have enough gold now that I'm gonna do a little bit of purchasing over here to get this city up to speed. I'm gonna grab a watermill and a builder for it. Spent quite a bit of my gold to get this city up and running. But it should pay for itself in the long run, this city. Especially just the amenity alone, actually, should do the trick. Let's do production here. We have A.O. Mori. Grab a monument to expand your borders. We have a pikeman here. We can move these forward. He got two niter. Like, look at this. This is crazy. This just reinforces what I was saying earlier. This player has a huge advantage over me, just completely randomly. And that's the problem. The problem is that RNG is fine as long as it's not dictating an outcome. And let me clarify that. As long as it's not dictating a sort of a game, like something that could be translated into a win. Okay, so something that can be translated into a win and the player can't mitigate it. So for example, let's say my character just has like a 10% chance to crit you and kill you instantly, you know, that's bad RNG. But if you give me armor, if you give me tools to deal with that RNG, that I can mitigate that risk, then yeah, sure, that's good RNG. But this is just bad RNG. This is just like, oh yeah, you don't get this strategic resource, you're shit out of luck. Sorry, buddy. And that's what that feels like. Actually, I could probably purchase upgrade. Oh no, that's siege units. 33 turn bombard. How much would it be to purchase a bombard? 925. Gold. That is a lot. However, they do a lot of damage. They do. I'm gonna grab a bombard. I think purchasing a bombard here makes sense. Grab me an armory. Get you the production. Librarily. I could definitely use the amenities, so I'm gonna grab an entertainment complex in this city. We're stabilizing our civilization. You're gonna need to do a little bit of thinking about where your campus goes. Okay, let me do some pins here. I think I actually need to get rid of this pin because I just placed one. Get delete. And deleting any more of these. Okay, I need you to actually harvest that. My god, my turns are taking a very, very long time. Okay, we harvested that. And now you should be working the farm, right? No. Never mind. Yep, just completely disregard what I said. We're gonna do what here? This city has what? A complete lack of production. Well, it has actually a pretty good production tile up here. If I could drop a industrial hub there. Let's see here. Yeah, scooch in there. Turn on the fish. Go back into the water and go around, you goofball. We have here, get this mine online. Excellent. And then we have a knight to bring to the fight. And these goddamn missionaries are in my way again. You know I killed one of Russia's cities, right? Because he did what you're doing right now. Like, I just wiped him off the map because of what you did. Oh, I only purchased that this turn. Yeah, the turns are taking a very long time now. Okay, we have a builder here. And not much to do with him. Were you using that tile? You were using that tile. Yeah, work that. Work it, work it, work it, work it, work it, work it, work it. Who's growing to that wheat is a good question. Huh? Who's growing to the wheat? Grow to the wheat. Where are you even growing to? It doesn't give me a growth tile. Huh. Interesting. Interesting. I mean, annoying. Annoying. Not so interesting. Go up to Okayama and see if they need any help. They could probably use a tile improvement or two on their fish. Caraval, you have completed your task, so why don't you make your way somewhere else? We don't actually have a target. I think I might go for Brazil next because he's right beside me. And I think I could probably take Fortaleza with just the naval units, actually. If I get those naval units over here. There's a settler over there that's not really much use to me, but I might be able to capture it. He seems to be making offers. I'm not interested in your offers. I want your everything. And I will be taking it from you post haste. Get up onto the hill. Shoot here. Shoot here. Move there. This guy is ready for an upgrade, it looks like. He didn't get any experience. You're not quite ready to slam that city. Next turn. Wait. Unit needs orders. You should be in automated exploration. Make our way over to Brazil. Should be able to do a quick boom and knock that out really fast. We have here a cannon type unit. Go over there and do a little of exploration. Go over there and do a little exploration. This is where the commerce herb is going to go. And actually, I would prefer if you... Well, I suppose the food there is fine. I think I'm going to harvest that to get the extra population. Yeah, now go there and get that amenity online. You need to go around the thing. I don't know why you decided to go that way. I think I clocked that when I originally sent him over there and then I just forgot to change it. Let's see here. Library? You made a builder because you did need a builder, didn't you? You had a couple tiles that were not... You had one tile that was not improved. Actually, two. So go there and improve that. Now, grab the library. Because I think the next version of the library has you housing in it. Right? Now, use... Production. You've got a little bit of an interesting position here. Because you just built in amenities. You could use housing. That would be giving you a little bit of food. Market will be nice for gold. Although we're making an absolutely outrageous amount of gold anyway. I think we need traders. Oh my god, I've been forgetting to build traders. I have traitorized my own people by forgetting to build traders. I could purchase a watt. But I need more faith. I need more faith buy. faith buy. I'd love to faith buy some units. We'll grab a... We'll just keep the city busy for now. For any of you who don't know, that is a very poor version of the Cork accent. And the Cork accent is one to behold. Right. Oh, hey, am I... I'm not at war with you anymore. Great. Okay, Fortizella, I should be able to take that in like a turn or two. He's in my way again. Go there and get ready to shoot. You can't move and shoot. Soon you shall take the city. You could do damage, but I'm not interested in that. Wait, wait, wait. And wait. One more unit needs orders. You're making your way around. I'm hoping I'll be able to get up here and settle there, but I might have to settle somewhere else. It all depends on where all the barbarians are. Let's go up here and do a little scouting. Next turn. Ooh. Okay. We have a builder over here, which is where it belongs. And we're probably going to chop this out, I think. Yeah. We will chop that out. I don't like jungle tiles too much. They feel better, or they feel worse. I think I'll actually declare war in Brazil now. So let's go declare surprise war. I don't even care. Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Now the thing will go here and shoot the city, do quite a chunk of damage to it. Then you will go here and hit the city. You will plunder this trade route. Kaboom. Kaboom! You're going to shoot the city. You're also going to shoot the city. Really soften it up. Soon, we're going to make sure we block off the city so it doesn't have anywhere it can go. Capture that unit. Excellent. Unit needs orders. That's going to be the end of your turn. You should go there and start hitting this city. Even just to keep it busy. And yeah, let's chop here. That'll speed up the commercial hub. Oh, actually, I think I'm building a commercial hub here, so I can actually cancel, or not cancel, but delete that. And unit needs orders. We're going to drop a farm there. We'll drop a lumber mill on that tile. We'll do a little bit of scouting with this guy. Looks like some cities we could navally invade. Ooh. Pick that up on your way. I'm not too, you know, don't care too much if you get there or not. I thought I'd already built this, but I guess I hadn't. This tile is pretty terrible. One food, one hammer, one gold, one faith. Like, what a crap tile. Ugh, it just feels wrong. That's another thing. I think some of the tiles in this game just feel, ugh. Ugh. They just feel dirty and gross. Ugh. Okay. You're shooting us with your Gdansk archers? Your Gdansk memes? We have Kyoto. Let's see here, Kyoto. Brain? Hello, Brain? Is anyone there? Make me traitors. My brain turned off there for like a few seconds. I don't know. I don't even know how long that pause is, where I just, my mind went completely blank. I didn't have anything in it. What are you making? I guess you don't have anything to make anymore. So do you know what you're going to make me? That's right. Not wonders. You're going to make me units. It is time to make privateers. 17 turns for a privateer. Mother of God. That's a long ass time. All right, we're going to drop a farm here too. And then we're going to get these two fish online. Skip turn. Carvel, what are you doing? Go, just do a little exploration for me. Kill here. Almost a kill. We should shoot this city again. Kaboom. Doing severe damage to it. Probably less good to attack with this ship, but it still does damage, so... okay, you should almost completely eradicate this city with that shot now. I meant to upgrade this guy, but I forgot. Okay, we've killed Sumeria. Sumeria has been voted off of the island. We're going to keep the city. Okay, so now is where we go full... Well, almost full production. We're not quite going to go full... Full meme, but we will go almost full meme. Unit needs orders. Get that online, please. Thank you. Get that online, please. Thank you. And you're going to make your way over here to get these online. Although you could use food, right? You're not working that. You're working these kind of tiles, but it's okay. I think it would be good if plantations perhaps had the same... shared an adjacency bonus for food with farms. I think that would make them stronger, actually. I think more adjacency bonuses in general would be really cool for this game. I don't know where this trader came from, but I'm not against it. Krakow could be a lot of gold. Amsterdam could be a lot of gold. But Krakow, Amsterdam would be more gold, but Krakow would be more production. I think I like the production. Get that extra little one production, dude. It's a lot. Danger. What danger? There's no danger here, you goof. Garrison strength 40. It's almost time for you to get out of there, but you should hit that city one more time. Choose production. Okay, you still got room for stuff, so why don't you make me a harbor? Didn't you have a builder over here somewhere? I'm pretty sure you did. Get that harbor online. Now it's time for you to also start building things that are not what you want to normally build. I think you're going to make a commerce. Yeah, you're going to make the commerce hub first. And you're... Oh. Samaria lives? Oh. Well then. Shoot here, send some caravels over to deal with it. I thought I killed Samaria, but I guess I didn't. Whoops. Oh well, this is bad. Although a single caravel wouldn't be able to take a city, I don't think. Cities are pretty resilient. Although they're not as strong as they used to be in Civ 5. With growth tiles. Another problem with growth is... Yeah... There's no way to turn growth into anything else if your land is bad. It feels like things are tied too heavily to land in a bad way. Some of the things are good, don't get me wrong. But it feels like you have no way to turn bad land into, you know, something other than just being behind the entire game. Yeah, emplacement is pretty good. We're going to rest up on this guy. Get this horseman to start killing all these missionaries. We'll be able to push over with a bombard soon. Unit needs orders. I gave you your orders, for the love of God. But you would not listen. How come I can't walk from this tile onto the harbor? That's interesting. Isn't that what the harbor is supposed to do? Misha, you want Misha back? No. Fuck you, Peter. You send your spies after me, and then you're like, oh, hey, here's these gifts. Please give our spy back. No. Anyway, that's going to be the end of the episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm trying to do, like, slightly longer episodes, around about a half an hour, to see how you guys feel about them. Make sure you guys give me feedback on whether or not you think that's cool. Make sure you give me feedback on the things I talked about, some of the random thoughts that I hit on in this episode. If you want to see more episodes of this, make sure you leave a subscribe on the channel. That'll get you notified when the new videos come out. And if you want to directly support my channel, leave a like on the video. It will directly impact my ranking on YouTube and, you know, get me more visibility, more viewers, and, you know, potentially more money. Who knows? If you want to... I did the comment, subscribe, like, subscribe. Look. You know the drill at this point. Thank you very much for watching. I love you all, and bye-bye.